from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Escape fugitive David Hobson is in custody. Tuesday evening, U.S. Marshals arrested him in Rochester, New Hampshire, near a market basket. Investigators say that Hobson was taken at gunpoint just after 6 p.m., but went without a struggle. Marshals say they captured him with the help of a family friend. They say the friend knew Hobson was headed to Rochester. Police pulled over the car the Hobson was traveling in as it left the parking lot. The driver of the car was not arrested. The Somerset County District Attorney's Office says no criminal charges will be filed in connection with the crash that killed a Jackman boy back in July. 5-year-old Liam Mahaney was killed when a logging truck flipped on its side and spilled its load into a home along Route 201. Investigators said the reconstruction found that speed, the condition of the road, and the condition of the truck did not contribute to the crash. The DA says the driver either had a seizure or fell asleep and that the crash was a tragic accident. Well, in Augusta Tuesday, Governor LePage outlined his proposal for sweeping cuts to Maine's Medicaid system as all part of an effort to close a $120 million budget shortfall. According to the governor, one of Maine's biggest problems is that many Mainers rely on Medicaid, about 30% of the population. The governor wants to take that down closer to the national average, which is about 20%. While the governor's proposal looks to keep as many programs as possible for the elderly and the disabled, hardest hit will be the optional programs not required by the federal government, including care for 19 and 20-year-olds and adults without children.
It's a real problem that at some point it needs to be dealt. And I just feel that we need to go at it now because I can't make money.
We focused on the optional eligibility programs, and those are the ones that we have put forward in this budget.
The governor hopes to begin implementing the cuts by this April, providing the legislature approves it in January. With the cost of college on the rise, the University of Southern Maine says it is offering up an additional $1 million in new scholarships to high school students. USM says the money will go toward 83 high school seniors enrolling in the fall of next year. The undergraduate scholarships range anywhere from $2,000 to $13,000 per year for both in-state and out-of-state students and will be awarded for a total of 4 years as long as students meet academic standards. A new poll is out looking at everything from the governor's job approval rating to how Mainers feel about the economy. The poll conducted by the Pan-Atlantic SMS Group shows more than 43% of Mainers either strongly or somewhat approve of the job that Governor LePage is doing. Just over 50% either strongly or somewhat disapprove of his job performance. In the race for the U.S. Senate next year, nearly 60% said they think that Senator Olympia Snowe should be reelected. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Stay with us for latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.